Hey there, welcome to my channel. Let's continue with our episode. Last episode we have covered some of the vendor functionality. So in this episode we will continue with the vendor and we will additionally add the food functionality also. So let's continue with the project. So here last time we have updated our vendor profile and vendor service. So here we will add our food functionality. So let's add quickly. We will create a food here and we will list out the created foods first. Let's go to vendor controller and here a couple of methods we will add.
I will be and
so to create a pod again we will add a file inside the DTO and this time it will be like right, so this mask is enough for a while. Now we will go to our vendor controller here. So here a couple of things we need to do right before adding the food. Okay. Number one, we need to have one model. That is, we need to create just like we have created earlier for vendors. So same way, we need to create a model for our food. Okay, here. So here we will. Here, as you can see, we have commented this food section. So we will uncomment this one here and we will uncomment here also. And foods will be necessary. Good. Now create a model here. This vendor ID will be necessary because to find out the specific foods by specific vendors to list out, right? So that will be useful for our further work, but beforehand we are just adding these things. That's good. So now we will create our schema. So now our food model is ready here. Now we need to implement this model in the vendor controller. Once we are going to this function add food, first of all we need to find out the vendor, right? Because here we have added some extra parameters, as you can see these foods. Every time while we will adding some foods, it will automatically get added to this food items, and which is a kind of reference of the object ID. It will always just keeping a reference to the food model. So while we will retrieve the specific vendor or restaurant, then we will get the all listed food of that specific restaurant from here. That will be very, very helpful. So by keeping this functionality, we need to search for the vendor first here, right before adding the food. Okay, then we will create the specific food, and we will add the created food to the vendor foods items. Create, and we will provide all those necessary information here. First of all, vendor ID will go. That is, we will be pined from vendor here. That is, we have done imported, I guess. Because the images we will take care from not from here, from some different source, in terms of like we will upload the images, but in this case I'm just sending some empty images here. These are the parameters which is needed to create the food. Okay, once the food is created, then we will look for if it is successfully created the put, then it will push the created put to vendor's puts array, and it will save the vendor with along with the existing changes. Good. And finally, it will return back the safe result from the vendor. Good. So let's have a try from the postman. Here, I think this add food is now hooked up with the router, right? No, it is not. So here we will add food. Because here we no need to authenticate once again. These are the routes where authentication is necessary, so I kept like this way. But if you are mixing something where let's say your food get food is not needed the authentication at that time, we can shift these things to on the top of the authentication, or we can use the directly this authentication in everywhere wherever it is necessary, and wherever it is not needed, we can keep it blank. That's good. Okay, so let's have a try from here. From postman, but before that we need to make sure like our data has to be clear, because the new vendor we have added like this put options here. We can delete this data from the MongoDB. Right, so now step save vendor controller. Why it is giving this error? Because we have made some changes on the vendor vendor model, so we need to provide explicitly this put option also. We will go to the vendor controller, admin controller, where we have created our vendor. As you can see, it is complaining here. So here we will do we will put, and we will pass empty array. Then I think it will go away. Yes, it's gone now. Alright, so we have cleared our database, so we will create one more vendor right here. Yeah, vendor is created now. One more vendor we will create, let's say second restaurant, and this will be our taste.com. Yes. Oh, that's good. So we will log in from vendor here. Taste.com, and yeah, we are getting the signature also here. So just to copy the signature from here, copy, and now we will go to here, and we will paste here, update. Now we can get the vendor profile here. Yeah, it is getting perfectly right. So we will add food here. Already we have added the parameters, right? So let's see. Yeah, that's perfectly fine. So as you can see, the food has been created now. Now we will add one more food here. Small burger, small, and the price will be absolutely half, maybe 70 5. And yeah, it's added now, right? So now there are two foods are available inside this specific restaurant. So adding food is working perfectly fine. So let's go to the vendor controller and we will list out the available foods here. All right, so we able to get the created foods here. And the thing is left, we will add the image upload functionality along with the food also here in add food. Okay, so in this vendor controller, a couple of things we need to take care of. How we can pass the image file and file name to the database, that is we need to take care of. Here in vendor route, import a library that is called Malter.
So here you want Malter.
So Malter is a kind of library which is handling our file upload functionality here in Node.js. So that is we will import here. Right before implement Malter, we need to configure Malter here. That will be our. So we will simply save our files, image files inside the images directory. So that is we have created here. Yeah, this is the images directory. Next we will use our file name, that is will be file name we will keep unique. So to make a unique file we will use new date
and do string and plus and present file originally so now here we will leave one button, then we'll be our list case will be model and the last source will be new source and
it will be a kind of array we will have attribute will be attribute name will be we can keep the file and images, that's up to you. Images and will be maximum limit will be 10 images, let's say, and we will simply pass these images in wherever it is required. Let's say here it is required images, right? Let's go to add food here. Right before the create food here we will deconstruct our request. So have you seen we are having here files? So these files, Malter is injecting this file, just I mean the way we did for user, the same way. Okay, so we can get these things and but we need to cast it. File will be a kind of array of files, so that will be express the Malter files file object will have a lot of things like in terms of like file name and original name or file path, a lot of things it will have, but we need to store only the file name which is required here, so that is we need to keep save. So now it's a kind of string array. Yeah, that's good. So this is we will assign here. Good. No, not files, images. It's good. Okay, but to serve the files we need to add a couple of things here in the index file right after this this body first here. This will help us to access the image files from our server. That is we will take care. Now let's check it out to create a food along with the images here. So we are going to switch to from data. So these are the information already there. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to delete these images from here. Okay. The way you can add the image field here, just add the name of the field, in our case images, and here here in this right hand side corner you can change the type of the field, which is going to be like file, and we will select files and open. Okay, two files has been selected. Now burger big from second restaurant. Okay, right, so send, it's created, right? So let's say create a couple of more foods. All right, so we have plenty of foods right now, that's good. So now let's check it out from the food section in terms of get foods. Here we will get the list of all the foods. See, some of the foods which is we have created earlier, its file name is mock.jpg, but newly created foods, as you can see, the file name is different now, right? So we can get the files from here by simply going to this image directory. As you can see, these are the files, right? That's good. So it is getting uploaded. Now what we can do, we can go to vendor controller and we can add the profile picture also. That will be necessary because while the user will look for a vendor or look for a restaurant, then you should have to see some kind of the restaurant images. So that is we need to upload here. So we will add one more route here, right after the vendor update vendor profile here. Copy all those things from here and use it here. So this section will not go, and find vendor, this is required, and we will finding the images here, files, the same way, but this time instead of this thing, images will be a kind of array, so that is we will push it here. So again we are saving the vendor here. So update vendor cover image, we need to hook up with the routes. So here go to vendor route, we will create one more route here. Now let's try this this route, update profile, this one we will save as update cover image. Good. So here in the body section we will not provide all those things. Instead of we will provide the prompt data, and we will add images, and it will be kind of file. We'll select file, let's say this thumbnail. Okay, and we will send in here. This is not profile, cover image, send. Okay, it is not going through, why undefined, something is going wrong. Okay, because why it is going wrong, we have not passed the images to this this function. As you can see, there is no images is there, the way we are sending images to food here. So here we need to provide images. Good, save. Right, go now. Update profile here. Now again send this data. Wow, that's good. As you can see, this is cover images available there here. So now we will check it out, like whether the cover image is available inside the images directory or not. Yeah, this is done. See, it's there, that's good. Right, so that's all for today. In the next episode we will work on the shopping section, and we will add some more functionality on the vendor and admin, so where we can see the availability of the foods for a specific area, and after that we will move forward to the user module, where we can see the user can access the food and user can access the card and all those things. All right, so thank you so much for watching this video tutorial. If you really like this video tutorial, give me a thumbs up, and if you have not subscribed my channel, subscribe it right now, because a lot of interesting topics it may come, and your encouragement is really really matter for me. Thank you so much.